What's up, folks? Dave Swift here with another episode of That LTD Life, the series where I dedicate my entire existence to eliminating those pesky monthly subscription fees and instead laser focus on lifetime deals to keep your overhead costs as low as possible. Today, I am looking at Sendr over on AppSumo. You can see this one starts off at just $59. Now, when I watched the promo video for Sendr from AppSumo themselves, they said it was a video personalization tool. So I opened it up and you can imagine I was surprised when it looks more like Google Sheets or Microsoft Excel than a video creation tool. So what the heck is going on here? I figured it out. It's actually pretty cool. There's a lot good here, some not so great. I'm gonna show you exactly how it works. We're gonna speed run through this entire thing. You don't got a lot of time. Let me show you how Sendr works. Now, first of all, I'm gonna be using the $59 plan. It is increasing in price in about 38 hours or so. So if you watch this video in the future and it's more expensive, my apologies. If you wanna support this content, I do have an AppSumo affiliate link in the description. If you click that before making a purchase, it greatly helps me out so I can create more videos like this. And thank you to everybody who has clicked my links this week. Does not go unnoticed. All right, onwards. Let me show you how this tool works. Because like I mentioned, it's actually kind of confusing at first until you get it. And then you're like, oh, that is actually pretty cool. So here's what we do. We create our account, we're on the home screen, and it asks us to create a table. A table is the place where your contacts are going to live, and then we're gonna use AI and web scraping to enhance that data and actually make it super powerful. Then we could just export our list back out and do whatever we want with it, or we can use their template section to build dynamic websites and dynamic media like video and audio that pulls in data from our AI and web scraped enhanced table. Get it? I thought so. Let's go ahead and show you how this works. So first of all, we want to get some contacts in here. I could do that with a CSV file, or I could bring them in from Apollo, or just scrape LinkedIn, add in a LinkedIn post. I've already done that here. I found this LinkedIn post. Where was it? It's right here. This is a public post. I don't know who these people are. I don't know who Steph is. So I'm not trying to call attention to them or anything, but you know what? They mentioned that they are a bunch of agency owners. And I thought those could be good clients. And I went ahead and grabbed the URL for this, just clicking on the triple dots right here, get the URL, then go back over into Sendr. And when you add in your table, which I'm showing you what it looks like right here, but essentially all you do is you add the post commenters or the post reactions, put that URL in, and it's gonna go out and it's gonna scrape all of that data. Now, you gotta kind of be careful here, because if you grab, let's say, a LinkedIn post that has 5,000 comments, well, it's gonna use all of your credits right away, because every single commenter, well, assuming that they're all different people, they're going to count as a credit as it goes out and grabs their data. And there are a set number of monthly credits that we get. So I'm on tier one here. I got 500 credits. I started low and just got a post with like 4 comments. So here it is. Here are the 4 commenters. And I've already enhanced this quite a bit. But when I brought it in, it just has the comment URL. And that's essentially it. But you can beef it up really, really easily. So go over to the data studio here, this little button. If you miss this button, the tool gets really confusing. So let me point this out. There's a contact section over here that doesn't have that button, but otherwise looks identical. If you buy a code of this and you're like, where was that thing? Like he said there was a enhance button or something and I don't see it. It's in the home section. Very, very confusing. You go to home, open up your table, then go to the data studio. Here, you can do all of this cool stuff. Like you can find the email addresses of people. And guess what? It nailed it. It got all 4 email addresses. They are right over here, right here, find email. You can see the stuff that has been enhanced because it has the little AI stars next to it. Now, if I wasn't certain that these email addresses were authentic, well, guess what? There is a tool for that as well. I can verify the email addresses. So I'm gonna go ahead and find the column and it found it for me, honestly, find email and then go to next step. It's gonna use 4 credits and I'm gonna run this on all of the rows. And now I've got my find email column and then it's gonna go ahead and verify that these emails are real and authentic. And sure enough, they are all valid. Now from here, we can do any number of things. We could go out to their LinkedIn profile and scrape every last inch of it, which is what I've already done. So I did this thing right here, enhance or enrich LinkedIn profile. And if you look, we've got their company's domain name. We've got their company logo. Now what's really cool is I can use this for my cold outreach. I can use this for my landing page. I can mention their company name. I can grab their logo, put it on the landing page. So it's gonna look ultra personalized, like you just spent a ton of time for putting together like a proposal that's just for them. I really love this one right here, nearby meeting location. So if you're trying to schedule in-person meetings, like cold meetings, well, you'd be like, hey, find their location, and you grab that off of their LinkedIn profile, and then you know where you're located. So we're gonna propose like, hey, let's meet at this coffee shop halfway between us. That is gonna seem really authentic, like scary authentic. If, hey, I'm gonna be at the Starbucks, you know, 20 minutes from your house, like you wanna grab, I'll buy you a coffee. We can talk about your business, and there you go. You got yourself a foot in the door. So I don't know, I was just really surprised at how useful and cool this tool actually is in terms of just filling out the data that you want on a contact. It seems so frequently with like scraping tools, it'll get some of the information that's useful, but then just kind of leave you wanting more. And there's no way to really fill it out without just hiring a VA to go and like figure it out, like go to town. So yeah, just be able to click a few things and get all of the data that I wanted. Super cool. But it does not end here at all. There's also this option to create your own prompt. So I could have it write an email. I could say, hey, write me a cold outreach message. And I could include the dynamic data that's already been scraped. So I can say, write so-and-so, like first name, and here are all of my table columns. So I can say, write Emma, write Stuart, write Antonio, and it's gonna rerun the prompt using every single instance on the entire table. All right, so I finished my message here and I said, write first name a cold outreach message and offer to help them stay relevant in the age of AI. They own the recruiting agency, and then I used their company name, and I said that their main competitor is, and then I gave them that as well. How did I figure out the main competitor's name? Well, I'll show you. It's just one of the data studio options. But first, let's write this cold outreach message. So we're going to run this on all four rows. It's going to take four of my credits, and it is writing the message right over here. And here it is. Let's take a look. It says, hey, I admire your group's commitment to excellence in recruiting. As AI reshapes our industry, I can help you leverage innovative strategies to stay ahead of search solutions and attract top talent. Now, it just threw in their main competitor right there. That's a little bit more compelling than your random cold outreach email. But you get the point here. It looks pretty nice. I could easily just export this. Oh, first, let me show you. This is how I found their competitor right there. Boom. Goes out and finds a main competitor for each company. If I was happy with this and I just wanted to send cold email, let's go back to the home screen. So click out here. You can click the triple dots, download the CSV. It's got the emails in there. It's got all of the contact info. We're good to go. We basically just enriched our list, especially if we started by uploading a CSV. We just made it more powerful. But it doesn't have to end there. We can also use their template system to create a full-blown landing page that is templated out using those placeholders, those dynamic tokens, and then customize it with audio or video that has also got dynamically inserted audio bits. Now, that part doesn't work as well, if I'm honest. Like, it's not as good. The concept is really cool, but it's not quite as well executed as everything else. So let me show you. We're going to create a new template here, and this is our website builder. It's a kind of foolproof website builder, which means it's not super customizable, but it's very nice looking. Like, it gets the job done. It has all of the normal like business type of sections you might want to see. So I'm going to go ahead and choose a focus message right here. And then basically I fill out this form over here on the left, and everything that I want is going to populate here in the center. So I'm going to add in a heading, and you guessed it, I can use variables here. So I just clicked on the little stars right there, and I'm going to create my own variable. I'll say company name. And then later on, we're going to map this up to our table that we basically scraped and used AI to put together earlier. So is company name ready for AI? That's going to be my heading. And then I can add in a video or an audio recording. Now, I can do this right here inside of the application. To be truthful, it's not that great. There's no editing tools. I recommend Dedan, which is a tool I reviewed just recently over on AppSumo. It's got a really great editor built in, so you'd be able to get the perfect take. You can do screen recordings. It's going to look really good. The editor here, not so good right now. But yeah, you can do Dedan and then just pop it right in. That's going to look good. But for now, I'll just record. How about a little bit of audio? So we can do this. I'm going to use my phone as the microphone. We'll choose the settings over here, and then I'm going to hit record. All right, 3, 2, 1, here we go. Now, if I screw this up, there is a little restart button right up here. So I'm obviously going to do that. We're going to run this again. I'll hit record. Hey, Susan, I was wondering if you are ready for the AI revolution. I noticed some things and I really think I could help you out. Hit me up. Maybe we can find a time to chat. Even just a quick Zoom would be great. All right, thanks for taking the time to listen to this. Okay, silly, stupid message. I would never send anything like that, to be clear. If you you receive a message like that from me, it is clearly AI. But here we go. I've got my message right here. I can listen to it.
I was wondering if you...
But there is no trimming. There is no editing. It's whatever you recorded. That's what you're going to get. But what is cool is I can enable dynamic audio. It's going to transcribe the recording that I just made. And then I can choose one word and one word only to replace with something from the table. So I'm going to use the first name right here, Susan, and I will choose first name as my dynamic variable. Now, let's say I wanted to make Revolution be the company name. Well, as soon as I do that, it's going to remove Susan. So you get one word. Remember that before you start your recording. Don't be like, hey, name at company. It's not going to work. Now, I can preview the audio down here. So I'm just going to replace Susan with Johnny and I can hit preview. And now my audio is generated. Let's go ahead and check this out.
Hey, Johnny. I was wondering if...
So it's a little bit weird, right? Because I kind of shouted Johnny and it didn't really sound like me. But yeah, that's how it works. Like I mentioned, it's not the best part of the tool. Everything else it does is really cool. The AI stuff in terms of audio and video, lagging behind a little bit in my opinion. Anyway, we're gonna keep this one. We'll save changes. And you can see this is basically how you build out a web page here. You just go and you add a section, you fill out everything in that section, then you can add another one. So we can do a calendar link. We could do an FAQ section. We could add in some testimonials. Very, very simple to add all of these sections, then you just got to go through and fill out the content to make it look good. When you're all done, go ahead and hit save. Then we can go back out to the home screen, open up our table, go to the data studio and personalize the pages. So I'm going to go ahead and I named them all the same thing. I think it was this one right here, my latest one. And then I can just map everything, right? So first name is going to go to first name. And then I've got company name. That's the only other one I used. But you can imagine I could have used the company logo or their company domain name. And it would have been really, really compelling. All right, there we go. I have mapped the company name, head to the next step. And basically it's gonna go ahead and create a personalized page as well as personalized audio for all of my contacts. The page is gonna cost me 1 credit. The audio is gonna cost me 2 credits. So you repeat that times 4, we're up to 12 credits for running this. Let's go ahead and create it. And now what it's gonna do is add a separate column for the personalized audio. And it's also going to add in a separate column for the personalized page. So here we go. Now I could make this my own domain name if I got AppSumo's tier 3 or above. You can see here custom domains or subdomains are available on tiers 3 and 4. I'm on lowly tier 1, so I don't get that for the demo, but you get the idea. And here's what the website would look like. So it says, is Sendr Group ready for AI? And then it's going to leave a message.
Hey, Stuart.
And there you go. You can hear what that sounds like. So overall, I think pretty cool. I probably would lay off from some of the dynamic audio and video, but still fairly compelling. Now there's some analytics built in here as well. So, you know, I could copy this link. I could include it in an email, generate a preview GIF if I wanted to have that show up in my email as well. That's a pretty nice touch. And then inside of the tool, if I click on engagement, I could actually see when people visited that personal template. We've got a workflow section over here. This is essentially a bunch of links to Zapier integrations. I don't really use Zapier very often, or I try not to, but I think these are also only available. Zapier templates are only available in tiers 3 and 4. So kind of a bummer there. So there it is. That's Sendr. I'm pleasantly surprised by this one. I'm going to give it a 7.8 out of 10. Pretty decent tool. Definitely recommend checking it out, especially if you do a lot of cold outreach or you're considering getting into that game. If you got any questions about this tool, hit me up in the comments. Even leave me a message for the algorithm. It is greatly appreciated. Hit that like button if you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to use my AppSumo link before making a purchase. Thank you for watching. My name is Dave, and I'll see you in the next video.